Joining us right now, he's a member of the Senate Intelligence Committee, as well as the Armed Services Committee. He's a Republican from Arkansas, an Iraq War veteran as well. Did you accept the president's answer explaining why there was a direct linkage releasing those four Americans from Iranian prisons as part of this deal?
Well, first of all, it should have been a precondition for the deal. We should have been in a position 2 years ago, not where we were asking Iran to come to the table, but where Iran was pleading with us to come to the deal. And a precondition to doing that should have been that they release all their hostages. This just gets back to the fundamental problem with this agreement, is that we are making a nuclear agreement with an outlaw regime that hates America and sponsors terrorism around the world and holds Americans hostage. And they can get a nuclear weapon whether they break this deal, as they've done with most major agreements in the last 36 years, or whether they follow every detail of the deal.
But the president says for all practical purposes, Iran's program is going to be dramatically diminished. Any effort that they're going to try to do to develop some sort of nuclear weapon for the next 10 years, maybe 15 years, give this an opportunity to succeed, he says.
Wolf, it's simply not the case. And just think about what's going to happen in the short term, putting aside their nuclear program. In the coming months, Iran is going to receive up to $150 billion of sanctions relief that they're going to use to support known terrorist organizations like Hezbollah and Hamas. The president himself acknowledged that. The arms embargo is going to be lifted, so they're going to be able to rearm their conventional military. And then ultimately, they might get nuclear weapons by breaking this deal at covert sites, or they might get nuclear weapons in 8 to 10 years. Now, maybe their behavior will change in 9 years, Wolf, but 9 years ago, Iran was trying to kill me and to kill my soldiers. We were lucky, but over 500 American soldiers were not. We shouldn't be making a nuclear arms agreement with that kind of outlaw regime.
Assuming the legislation is vetoed by the president, the resolution of disapproval to ban this deal, to reject this deal, will the president have enough Democrats in the U.S. Senate to override a veto?
Wolf, I believe that Congress will kill this deal because the American people will repudiate this deal. Yesterday was probably the best day that this deal had. As the details come to light, it's not going to get better with time. For instance, we now know that Qasem Soleimani, the commander of the Quds Force, which is responsible for killing Americans in Iraq and Afghanistan, will receive sanctions relief, as will the Quds Force. We also know that the United States has committed to helping protect Iran's nuclear facilities from sabotage. What in the world could that possibly be except trying to stop Iran, stop us and stop our partners from undermining Iran's race towards a nuclear weapon? As more and more of these details come to light, I do believe that the American people will repudiate this deal and Congress will kill the deal with a veto-proof majority.
All right, we'll see what happens. Senator Tom Cotton of Arkansas, thanks very much for joining us. We have a lot more analysis.